3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth. Jesus, peace be upon him, doesn't say that, see, go and meet Bartimaeus, the blind person who I gave sight. Why don't you ask the woman with issues, who only on touching me she was healed? He didn't refer to the 2,000 pigs he had killed to heal a possessed man. He doesn't say that the 5,000 and the 3,000 people he fed with a broiled fish and with bread. He says, no sign shall be given to you but the sign of Jonah. Jesus, peace be upon him, is putting all his eggs in one basket. The sign of Jonah. And for a person to know the sign of Jonah, he doesn't have to be a scholar of the Bible. He doesn't have to be a doctor of divinity, because it is taught in Sunday school. And in most countries, including India, irrespective whether you're a Christian or a Muslim or a Hindu, somewhere or the other, it is taught either in comics or in moral science lessons, the sign of Jonah or Jonah and the whale. They know. But if you want to know the sign of Jonah actually in the Bible, in this big book, the sign of Jonah is less than 2 pages, less than 1.5 pages. I had the Xerox copy done from the same Bible to make it easy. Less than 1.5 sides. Less than 1.5 sides. Only 4 chapters. And to find 1 page in encyclopedia of more than 1,000 pages is difficult. But everyone knows the outline of the story. That Almighty God, he asks his messenger, Jonah, peace be upon him, to go and deliver the message to the Ninevites, to go to Nineveh. But he says, these Ninevites, they are so sinful. What will they listen to the message? He thinks that they will make fun of me. It will be a waste of time. So he goes to Joppa, and from there he's setting sail to Tarshish. Now while he's at sea, there's a huge storm. And it was the superstition of the mariners of that time, that if there's a storm at sea, it is because someone has disobeyed the master. And they had their own ways in trying to find who was the person responsible. They had the system of casting of lots. And when they cast lots, it comes to the turn of Jonah, peace be upon him. And Jonah, being a messenger of Almighty God, he agrees and he says that, see, I am the person responsible. I was told by my master, Lord, to go to Nineveh, but from Joppa I am setting sail to Tarshish, running away. I am at fault. You take me and throw me overboard. But they say, this person, such a pious person, why should simply he be killed? So they try and stir the ship, but yet they are not successful. The storm is yet there. So he says that, why don't you throw me overboard? And finally they agree, and they throw him overboard. When they throw him overboard, the storm subsides. Maybe it was a coincidence. Later on, a big fish, a whale, comes and swallows Jonah, peace be upon him. Jonah prays to Almighty God from the belly of the whale. The whale takes Jonah, peace be upon him, for 3 days and three nights around the ocean, and then vomits him out on the seashore. What is the sign of Jonah? Jesus, peace be upon him, says that no sign shall be given to you but the sign of Jonah. For as Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of the whale, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth. Now I'd like to ask you a question. When Jonah was thrown overboard, was he dead or alive? Before you answer, I would like to make it easy for you. Let's see, Jonah volunteers. He says, I'm the culprit, I'm responsible, throw me overboard. If someone doesn't agree, maybe you'll have to break his leg, you may have to break his neck, you may have to twist his arm. But here he volunteers, so they don't have to do all that. So they throw him overboard. I'm asking a question. When Jonah was thrown overboard, was he dead or was he alive? Alive. The fish comes and swallows him. Was he dead or alive? Alive. He prays to Almighty God from the belly of the whale. Was he dead or alive? Do dead men pray? Was he dead or alive? Alive. The whale takes Jonah 3 days and three nights in the ocean. Dead or alive? Alive. Fish vomits him out on the seashore. Was he dead or alive? Alive, 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 alive. When a person is thrown overboard in a raging sea, he ought to die. If he dies, no miracle. If he's alive, it's a miracle. Fish comes and swallows him. He ought to die. He doesn't die. It's a miracle. 3 days and three nights, suffocation and heat in the belly of the whale. He ought to die. He doesn't die. It's a miracle. It's a miracle of a miracle of a miracle. Miracle of a miracle of a miracle. Jesus said, peace be upon him, as Jonah was 3 days and three nights, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights. As Jonah was 3 days and three nights in the belly of the whale, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights in the heart of the earth. Jonah was alive. But when I pose the question to my Christian brothers, and they are our brothers, they are our cousins, what do you call? They are brothers. When I pose the question to the Christians, that how was Jesus, peace be upon him, in the tomb according to you? And all of them say that he was dead. He was dead. I'm asking a question. Jonah was alive. Jesus, peace be upon him, was dead. So was Jesus, peace be upon him, alike or unlike Jonah? Like or unlike? Unlike. So Jesus, peace be upon him, does not fulfill the prophecy. He puts all his egg in one basket and says, no sign shall be given but the sign of Jonah. And here, the prophecy is not fulfilled. For the prophecy to be fulfilled, he should be alive. As I proved in the earlier part of my talk, he was alive. Otherwise, Jesus, peace be upon him, will be a liar. Nauzu billah, which we cannot agree. We respect him. We revere him. So for him to fulfill the prophecy, he should be alive. And Jesus, peace be upon him, was alive, as I proved in the earlier part of my talk. As I said, that for a person to be crucified, he should be put to death on the cross. If he does not die on the cross, he is not crucified. There are some people who may say that, see, here the main part of the sign is not dead or alive, it's the time factor, time factor. You know, 3 days and three nights, as Jonah was in the belly of the whale, so shall the Son of Man be 3 days and three nights. Three is mentioned four times. The main important emphasis is three, three, three. It is not dead or alive. I say, what is so unique about three? If I say, I took 3 days and three nights to reach Delhi, is it a miracle? What is so miracle about three? 3 days or 3 weeks? It's not a miracle. But they say, no, it is a time factor. Let's analyze whether Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, fulfills the time factor, which the Christians, some Christians say, is the main theme of the sign. As I said earlier, and we know that when we ask the Christians that when was Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, crucified, and according to the Bible, the Christians will say, on a good Friday. So we ask him, what is so good about the Friday? They say, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, died for our sins. Therefore, it's a good Friday. And if you read that it was, the trial was in a hurry, they were hurried for the trial, they were in a hurry to put him up on the cross, they were hurried to get him down, because as pastor said, no one can stay overnight hanging on the cross on the Sabbath, according to, he didn't mention the reference, Deuteronomy chapter number 21, verse number 23. The land will get cursed. So they were hurried to get him down. And they give the burial bath, and it is by the time late in the evening. He's put in the sepulchre late in the evening. And according to the Gospel of John chapter 20 verse 1, it was the first day of the week, Sunday morning, that the tomb was found empty by Mary Magdalene. So supposedly, Jesus was in the tomb on Friday night. Why do I say supposedly? Because the Bible does not say, when does Jesus leave the tomb? Maybe he left on Friday late night or Saturday morning. It doesn't say, agreeing that latest he might have left is in early morning on Sunday. So Jesus was in the tomb Friday night, supposedly. He was there in the tomb Saturday day, supposedly. He was there in the tomb Saturday night, supposedly. Sunday morning, the tomb is empty. So he was there for two nights and one day. But the sign says 3 days and three nights. 3 days and three nights. As Jonah was in the belly of the whale, so shall the Son of Man be in the heart of the earth. 3 days and three nights. But Jesus, peace be upon him, was actually one day and two nights. Is 3 days and three nights equal to one day and two nights? Is it equal? 3 days and three nights equal? No. So even the time factor which they boast about is not fulfilled. The real thing is, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was alive. For a person to be crucified, he should die on the cross. Just to make easy for the pastor in the rebuttal time he has, I list the major points proving that he was not crucified, he was not resurrected. Because